Kid Chris Show.
Just telling Dubs and everybody, I went to the 311 show over at Liquid Amphitheater this weekend. It was a busy weekend. Friday, you and I went out to 37th and Main.
Yeah, which is a good spot, right? It's cool, huh?
It was awesome out there. That is a great rock club.
It is. It's nice.
It just takes 7 hours to get there from where I left.
It's worth it once you get there.
It is worth it when you get there. And everybody was cool, too. Another thing is, too, I know it's early, but... You know, I really do appreciate when you want to buy shots, but I can't be drinking like that out of things.
Well, plus you got to drive yourself back and everything.
An hour drive after Jaeger bombs or whatever.
Did you have a Jaeger bomb?
No, I don't have, I can't, no way, I'm not doing any shots. I don't need any girls spiking those things and taking advantage of me, okay? Not a piece of meat.
That happens.
But I went to, I went over and checked out 311, okay?
Right.
And it was cool seeing everybody, a lot of hot stoner chicks. Love that band. But I went and watched the show, and it was unbelievable how, first of all, I thought 311 was a bigger band. It had, you know, huge arena, but there was hardly anybody there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't know. Like, half of it was full, and then the lawn had a good crowd up there. It's amazing. It looked like a Grateful Dead show, the way everybody was dancing to that music.
Just kind of like swaying in the wind on our own.
Yeah, it was pretty funny. That was hilarious. But I tell you what, I like 311. They come out, they open up with Down. You know that song.
Right.
People get excited.
That's good.
People are fired up and all that. And then it's just, it's Snooze City after that.
But you're probably waiting for what, Amber?
Not even that, because all the other ones sound like Amber.
That's true.
You know? I was like, wow, this is... This is why they really aren't heard anymore. You know what I mean?
Right.
It's like, God, I kind of wish...
Did it kind of turn into like a jam band kind of thing?
I didn't say long enough. I was gone after three songs, and I had to bail.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I was, you know, if I paid, I would have been very upset.
What a downer for you.
Well, you know, it gave me it was something to do, and it was fun going out there and watch Britney get her picture taken with all the creepy dudes that just hear her dirty songs and want to... Try to get with her.
Yeah.
She loved it every second of it.
Oh, she loves the attention.
Yeah, she does. It just puts
an expiration date on the relationship she has.
That's right. If I was that dude, I would not be going out to these events.
No way. Because you see dudes with their arm around her the whole time. Yeah.
And she poses weird, too. She always puts her leg back like a...
It's like a cheerleader kind of thing.
Yeah. It's funny looking at her in there. You know? And she witnessed, too, this girl just out of nowhere... was filling out a thing, and it put her phone number on it. She wrote like, sex, yes, please, and it put her phone number on there and gave it to me, this chick.
Nice, yeah, do it, right?
But I had to give it to Brittany. I said, here, you better hold on to this. We'll call her during the show or something. Because if I have too many drinks, I'll end up dialing her on the way home.
You'll call her? Hey. What's going on?
What's up? Yeah. Then I'll bail in the middle.
Like you did in high school where you just call and listen to her voice?
That probably would have been what happened.
That's a safer route for you. Listen to her breathing.
Yeah. But it was what a busy time. And then I went and checked out the UFC fight, which was another snore fest. That thing was brutal.
Those are hit or miss. That's what I think. Like, sometimes the matches are great.
Yeah.
Like 2 weeks ago we saw the ones and they were good.
Yeah.
But were there any big names besides Uriah Faber on this one?
You know, I'm still relatively new to it, but the Uriah Faber matchup was supposed to be a monster one because the Brazilian dude he was getting ready to fight, or that he fought,
was a monster. Right?
It was supposed to be just epic. And even Joe Rogan during the pay-per-view was going, this pretty much sucks.
Oh, wow.
It was a snore fest. And then Uriah Faber lost the title to, you know,
that dude?
Yeah. Five rounds of just of them just holding hands, really.
I saw another fight with him years ago, like maybe like 2 years ago. It was the same thing. Yeah. Them just dancing around.
Yeah, well, it was cool to actually get out and get away from that 311 show. To go watch guys hold hands.
Yeah, and I was actually upset I was going to miss that show. I wanted to see that.
No, I've never seen those guys before, and I don't know if I ever will again, honestly. I mean, you really have to, and there's people there. There was a guy there that saw them like 72 times or something like that. Yeah, I don't know. I know, you almost cursed. That's how upset you are.
No, really, I am. Yeah. I was like, what, 72 times?
And I love that Transistor album. You know, and that probably because it had a time for me where, you know, I was still living at home. It was years ago that album came out, and I just got fired from my first radio job. So all I would do is listen to that and, you know, other music of that time. So that's probably why I like that album.
But you don't want to hear like the whole.
I don't know. Everything. It all sounds the same. People make that joke all the time. But yeah, they would go into it. And the one guy, Nick, was all dressed up like a frat guy, dancing up on stage. It was just like he's just phoning it in. Like he doesn't care. He's a, and this guy, 311, made that much money where he owned his own island for a second.
What?
Who's giving him this money? Because well, what I saw, I knew I want my money back, and I didn't pay for a single thing. Dude,
those stoners buy pot, and they've watched the right, I guess 311 shows.
Yeah, exactly. They make so much money off of these stoners showing up, I guess. I don't know.
Are they like the new like Grateful Dead kind of thing?
No, because Grateful Dead had an audience. we'll get into a lot of the stuff that happened since the shooting on Friday when we got into that here on our show, and I was absolutely right. I said that picture was gonna, we're going to see who this guy is by noon, and right at noon press conference on Friday, we saw what the dude looks like.
Yeah.
But you know, his name it was released as James Holmes, but no. The news calls him the Joker. Because he dyed his hair.
Riveting.
Stop it. The Joker.
You think there was any, he had any like reason, like that was why he dyed his hair like that, or?
Yeah, because he's insane.
Right, nuts.
Come on. Not really much to figure out here. And you know, the news is so funny. They make it like, I was watching Fox News, of course, and I get sucked into it. Then every time they go to a break, they have to play that eerie music and then show the stills of people crying.
Well, it's like, look, we get it.
I know, we get it. It's like, come on.
They're trying to sell the story, Chris.
I know they are. But like, we all know the story, and we're already glued into it.
You're already into it.
I'm already glued into it. You don't need to scare me, all right? With the eerie music and stuff. Play some Bruce Springsteen or something in the background. Well, you know,
some while, of the boss?
Yeah. But it was scary watching it all this weekend, and today we're going to see what he looks like. He's going to court today, so we'll all be glued to that.
Definitely.
And then the eerie music while they're showing people crying, and then the victims, some of the people who survived, they talked to them this weekend, and that scares you, but of course you're glued in. But like Thomas and I were talking before we came on the air, what's the date that we all forget about this?
Right. It's going to go on that list that you have of things we forget.
Yeah, the things we forget.
I can't even remember all the things we mentioned last time because they're already out of mind.
Anthony Weiner, right? Casey Anthony, Cooney. Cooney 2012, remember that?
Yeah, that was a big...
Oh, everybody was all fired up.
That lasted a weekend.
Yeah, it did. Spamming everybody's Facebook wall with that, and then now it's on to the next one. Ah, forget those kids now. Forget it.
Yeah, what are they going to do for me now?
Yeah. Coming up at about 7:30, so about an hour from now, we'll be giving away... we'll be calling the person who qualified to ride on that Tommy Lee drum riser tomorrow during the Kiss and Motley Crue show. That's going to be a big rock show. And to ride on that drum riser thing during a solo... That's pretty awesome.
That'd be cool.
So that person, we will be calling at about 7:30. So if you qualified, you want to be a listener around that time for sure. And we'll be calling you and hooking you up. Now, if you don't answer the phone, we move on to the next one.
Next guy.
All right. And, you know, Kiss, too. What did he put out the other day? They have, like, Kiss lunch boxes. They got Kiss everything. You know, you go to the show, and you get, like, a copy of the show as you're leaving. You buy it.
And merchandise.
Yeah. It's actually pretty impressive. But it's to the point where, like, it's real hokey, and you're expecting that from Kiss. So they just get even hokier because they know, hey, this is where Kiss. This is what we do.
People will get it.
Yeah, so they make money off of that because it's like a cool collector's thing to get all the Kiss stuff. And remember, we had Gene on that one time, Gene Simmons, when we were announcing the show. And Gene was telling us about the new thing that they're going to be doing out at the show tomorrow.
Hi, Chris. It's Gene Simmons.
From
Kiss.
Yeah. Oh, man, that's great.
It's going to be the greatest rock show of all time. Tickets are available at kissonline.com. We're going to be selling mints at the show. We're going to be selling t-shirts, tour programs. We're going to be selling shoehorns. We're going to be selling hair plugs, Kiss makeup. You go to the Kiss concert. And also go to kissonline.com for any other information you need.
Wow, look at that. It's a plethora. It's like a buffet of Kiss material.
Who's the number one band in rotation? I'll answer it for you. It's Kiss. The number one band of all time. And we're inviting everyone who's going to see Kiss live after the show. You're going to get a copy of Kiss My Laughs. All of our favorite jokes. This is breaking news, Chris. I'm giving this to you as an exclusive.
Wow, so it's a book of jokes?
This is the announcement. Are you ready for this?
Sure.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Lettuce.
Lettuce who?
Lettuce in. We're Kiss. How about this? Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Orange.
Orange who?
Orange, you glad? It's Kiss that just charged you $200.
And what's the name of this book?
It's called Kiss My Last. Here, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Boo.
Boo hoo.
Why are you crying? It was Kiss that just raped you.
Oh, man, these are great.
Yeah. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Ketchup. Ketchup with Kiss on kissonline.com. Isn't that amazing?
Oh, man. Gee, this is why Kiss is the biggest, most electrifying band ever.
You're absolutely right. And one more thing I want to say to you, Chris.
Yes.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Gene.
Gene who?
Gene Simmons from Kiss. Isn't that unbelievable?
Oh, man, that
so
is
go
crazy.
Go to the concert. I'll be honest with you. What you get when you come in the door is you get a leaflet. The leaflet is Kiss My Laughs. It's a sample of the greatest joke writing. And then you go to kissonline.com and you get the actual book.
Man, this
but
is
I got to go. And this has all been brought to you by kissonline.com. We're not trying to plug. I'm just telling you the truth.
Okay. Well, right? Thank you. Thanks, Gene.
All right. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Hey, you know, we got a cool thing coming up. We're going to be going out and having a nice little party in the Bud Light boat up on Lake Lanier, Thomas. And everybody, if you go to kidchris.com, keyword Facebook, there's an event page up there. You can go and sign up and be a part of that and hang out with us. Why not? Tip back a few Bud Lights and hang out with us on a boat? That's coming up on the 4th.
Hot chicks.
Dude, it's going to be good. So we'll get more into it, too, as we get to throughout the week and stuff. But it's simple. Just go up there and sign up that you want to go. And you could be going with us and hanging out on Lake Lanier on the Bud Light boat. This thing's a big boat. We did it last year. And we just hung out and drank for like 8 hours.
I missed it last year.
It was awesome. It was a beautiful day, too. And watching, like, everybody was, like, jumping off the top of the boat into the water and stuff. And I'm all like, ah!
Yeah,
I get all nervous.
What are you doing?
I was wearing all black out in the sun. My forehead got all burned. I'm like, I'm so retarded. I can't even have a good time.
Dude, you're kind of an outside loser.
Yeah, right?
You can't do stuff.
So, but this time, I'm going to be prepared. I'm going to bring one of those, you know.
Are you going to wear a tank top?
No, I'm not wearing a tank top.
Come on, wear, like, a meshy tank top.
No, I'm not wearing a tank top.
And wear a visor upside down.
Yeah. Look, I'm kind of dumb, but I'm not like douchey.
And then just have like Kenny Loggins playing out of your phone the whole time.
I'm into that. Keep talking.
Right. Now I'm talking your language, right? We're having a good time.
Hey, Brittany, the intern, was just telling us she moved out of her house or out of her dorm this weekend and moved into a townhome with three of her friends.
Yeah.
I am going to be on the phone with an internet company very soon. We're going to install webcams. And we're going to be making some dough.
Yeah.
Imagine them.
Dude, people will watch that.
Pillow fighting in their juicy sweats. Right? Huh?
That's
just feathers everywhere,
right.
in their bikini top, in their bras. Oh.
Walking around in towels after they shower.
That's
all the
what
time.
Happens on those websites I go to. Those dorm websites. Everybody just starts having sex.
I don't know. After hearing her talk to some of her sorority sisters, they sound like the kind of girls that kind of walk around and fart all the time.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that thing's gonna smell.
Yeah.
Who wants that? Oh, excuse me. I'm all gassy this morning, too. But hey, later on this morning, this Motley Crue, you get to go ride on the drum thing that Tommy Lee has. Now, it'll be interesting when we pick a winner this morning who it's going to be because, you know, Tommy Lee's known for having that, you know, that third drumstick of his own there. So it'll be interesting to see if we pull a girl.
Should right? be excited.
Because if you're a guy, I mean, I guess it's cool to ride on that drum thing, you know, and you sit behind Tommy Lee as he's, you know, doing his solo and stuff. I think that's pretty cool. But for a chick, that's even better, you know? Like, if I won a chance to sit up on stage and get a lap dance from Kesha or whatever, I'd be like, yeah, nice. Sign me up. Yeah, I know. It's a girl. I apologize.
Yeah.
But, look, some of us are into that.
Some
of us,
I'm mad.
Some of us are old school.
Some of you guys are into the girls. I get it. Right. It's a new age.
Yeah, it is. You know, you're allowed, you know, but some places you're allowed to get married and, you know, to Steph Thomas. But, you know, some of us here are old school. We like girls. You know, that would be exciting. You know,
you and Jordan are the only people in
the only guys that are into that. The only guys that are into Kesha. You said it. What a dick.
I didn't even say
yes,
it.
Yes, you did. You and Jordan are the only guys. It's rude.
Whatever.
Jordan's really into that chick.
She 100%. It's weird.
Mm. Well, you know the thing, dude. She's got that sexy picture where she's laying there and some guy just, Spider-Man slung webs on her chest.
I forget, like by your not your standards, but the way you think, the dirtier she is, the hotter she is.
Yeah, so. She's got dough.
Yeah. Well, think at this that point. Makes her hot, actually. I take it back. I'm sorry.
Yeah. It's like, but, you know, my thing is, though, with her, it's like, you know, imagine how you go backstage, her meet and greets are probably like gangbangs and stuff. I mean, that's what I'm thinking.
It's people like it's kids. Go back at me. What are you talking about?
You leave me alone. All I got in my head now is Takesha gangbang, meet and greet, and Brittany and her friends wrestling around each other.
You're riled up, man.
Yeah, with oil. What does happen in like a girl dorm? I mean, you know, let's leave the
internet. I don't know, ask her. She lived there for what, over the last couple of years, right?
I think you're right. I think it's just disgusting
it
stuff.
It probably is. I bet you think of,
you know, knocking on each other's doors, asking them to borrow, like, you know, female things. Yeah.
Well, guys, it's just like Animal House.
No,
you know
it's
that
not.
Scene? No, it's completely not.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
I bet it's not exciting at all.
Like, it's actually fun. There's
fun for you.
Some ups.
Do girls sit around and talk like at a dorm? Is there girls that like go and have sex with their boyfriends in the dorms and stuff, and then and
sneak them out?
Yeah, things like that.
Well, see where I'm from, like it doesn't matter who's spending the night, like. Guys, girls, it doesn't matter. Because some, like, fraternities or sororities or even, like, universities, you have to have, like, a sign-in pad and, like, you can't have boys in.
But at your place, you can
just... Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Was there any... At your dorm, was there, like, a girl that, like, would take on a couple guys and things like that?
Not really.
Was yours a skank dorm?
No. Actually, I'm living, like, I just moved out with three random girls. I didn't know. I just moved in.
Yeah.
And that was, like, that was a little plunge I was, like, kind of nervous about. But they were actually pretty cool, but one of them had a boyfriend, and then two of them, like, one of them was, like, a computer nerd. Oh,
that's okay. Yeah.
That's fine.
That's who you want to live with.
But I was, like, man, I lucked out, because one of the girls, you know, the computer girl, she never came out of her room.
Yeah.
And then the other one was like at band practice all the time.
She's planning to shoot up the Spider-Man movie.
Yeah. Pretty much.
What about the other girl? Did she like bang her boyfriend a lot and stuff, and it was always like loud?
She was like the Susie homemaker. I come in and she was making this food. But the thing is,
I know.
No, but the thing is, it was always burnt. And I was like, come on, you seriously? But I guess that's where you learn.
See,
college.
I'm going to have to call and cancel those webcams we put in. I don't want to see girls cooking.
No, but the thing is, the townhome I'm moving in now, these are three girls that I actually know, so they're actually kind of cool.
It's going to be the F shop over there, Thomas.
Yeah, right.
It's
going to
be a line of guys,
I bet you it's a bunch of girls with no makeup on. I know.
Do you girls like ever sit around and talk about how, like, oh, man, he really gave it to me last night or anything like that?
Only in my close friends.
Really?
I mean,
what
it comes
say?
Up.
No, go
wow.
on.
I mean, we're not like dry. Come on, guys. Like we have to talk about something.
Oh, that's cool.
Well, like, when was the last time you told your girlfriends that your boyfriend gave it to you really good?
Yeah.
I mean, we have like girls' nights at like every now and then.
Wow.
And we like sit around and like, oh yeah.
Well, you're like,
really?
Like,
you know the Nicole girl I interviewed the other day?
A few months ago.
Okay. Like, she's like, oh, yeah. She got me into reading 50 Shades of Grey, and she's taking stuff from that book. She goes, oh, yeah, I told him this.
Wow. So she's
call us and
that's
tell
your
us
slutty
that.
Friend, huh? That's cool. Yeah, you need
she's,
to.
She's a little
she's
wild,
skanky.
But she's awesome. She's really not that bad.
Well, let's hope that virus spreads throughout that dorm.
There's no viruses. Yeah. We're all clean.
No, I know. But
are
I want
you,
you
guys
are you
living
get
with
dirty.
Her now or no?
No.
But you guys should move in together. Then I'll put webcams in.
That would be funny.
You guys drink some wine and start making out.
Do you guys all walk around in your underwear and stuff?
Yeah.
I used to have a really good friend, and we went on spring break together, and she walked around naked all the time.
Oh, my God!
And, you know, I wasn't used to that at the time. You know,
I used to do that to Thomas.
School.
When Thomas and I were living in a hotel in Texas together at a new job, I would like, go and take care of myself and then
you would walk
come out
wild
on
the... Sometimes they catch you off guard, and you're like, whoa!
No, I remember vividly. Like, it was a double bed, and then I was laying on the bed, and he goes, guess what I just did?
Oh, yuck!
And I was like, oh,
yeah, remember all the new interns?
Yeah.
Have a I'm meeting at my apartment and I come walking out naked.
Walk out naked on the
oh my God.
Guy interns.
I can never unsee that.
I don't know if it's worse or good than it was guy interns only.
Yeah, it was all good. It was all good.
He loved it.
We had this one intern, Gibby, that was really weird, and he went, oh my God.
But he didn't look away.
No, he didn't look away.
He was tool gazing.
Yeah, and we found out he was bi, so that's why. Man, so it was like, what a gift. Oh, I want to get an A.
When's the next sleepover at your house?
Actually, we're having one tonight.
Oh, really?
Yeah, dude. We're in, Thomas.
Let's go.
Hey, Dubs, can you try to find out how... I want to know how Batman did this weekend after all the chaos that happened. I'm sure it's number one.
I saw a report that it did just... it's supposed to do $160 million.
It's supposed to?
Yeah, it was supposed to come in just over what the previous one did.
Okay. So we'll see. I mean, I don't think...
I don't think it affected it at all.
No, man. Probably not. The nerds are like, I'll wear my utility belt and I'll be just fine. I've got here real quick, if you want to go through, you know, we were talking about 311 earlier and how music has changed and all that stuff. Here's the top songs from iTunes. This is what the stuff, and I like this better than like those Billboard charts and stuff, because this is where everybody is going to get the music now, is up on downloading it online and stuff. So here's some of the new stuff that's out, if you want to, let's see. I'll tell you what, I feel all right that I'm not connected to any of his music, because I don't care anymore.
It's too hard for you to keep up with it all.
Yeah. Like, I don't care that I don't like the No Doubt song. She is doing them a favor by getting them back together, because these guys are back to playing in the garage without her.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's number four. All right, that was number five. This is number four. So this is Fallen.
Kind of glad it's Fallen.
Yeah. Katy Perry, massive song. That's number three. Flo Rida. That's number two. And then this one. Jason Aldean. This is country.
That's number one.
Yeah. There you go.
Hat on.
Here's 10 years ago. You ready?
Yeah.
Ashanti. Ugh. I used to have to play all this stuff. It's the DIP plus the ROC. You'll be DOA. Okay, two people. Where are they?
Cameron and
Ashanti. I don't hear from her anymore. Don't hear from that guy anymore. Oh. This is a hero song of Chad Kroeger and Josie Scott.
That was a good song.
That was a good song. There's actually guitars in it and a band playing. That was 10 years ago, number two. That's
a
massive song.
See, this
is
when he was good.
Yeah. Yeah, this is when he just used to hate everybody.
Yeah.
Now he's rich.
I said it's getting hot.
Nelly was number one 10 years ago.
You love Nelly, too.
I did. I love this song. Remember when I used to wear that band-aid on my cheek?
Yeah.
No. I'm making a joke.
You did.
No, shut up.
No, you did.
Get out of here.
You were.
You're an idiot.
What happened was, we used to go places, he would sweat and it would come off.
No.
So he had a pocket full of more of them and he would put more of them on.
Right. Thomas is right.
Yeah. And then when he met a girl at the club, he would write her initials on it so we knew that
that's right.
That was the one.
Yeah,
for that
that's
night.
What I would do. I'd go to the club.
Or he would write his phone number on it and give it to her.
Yeah, that's right.
You wore a band-aid.
I made the joke. You can't run with it.
I'm already out the door. What are you talking about?
We have a secret celebrity coming on in about 15 minutes or so, okay? And Thomas has a clue for you. A clue. Go ahead, Thomas.
His brother never knew what he was talking about.
Okay. That's your clue.
That's the clue.
One more time, Thomas.
His brother never knew what he was talking about.
There you go. Guess what it is? I'll give you tickets for this Warped Tour. It's a good show, man. And coming up in a little while too, at 7:30, we'll pick our winner for the ride on the Motley Crue Tommy Lee drum set tomorrow night. That's gonna be big. So, you know, there's a show on TLC called The Virgin Diaries, which, what a great idea. And the guys here at the radio station turned me on to it. I watched some clips up online, and I saw this one dude who was interesting. His name was Skippy. And Skippy's on the phone, and he claims to be a virgin. Hey, Skippy.
Hey, guys.
How you doing? No,
I'm more than claim. I live it. Yeah.
Yeah. So you are a virgin.
I'm 100% a virgin.
How old are you?
34.
Whoa, man. Boy.
Yeah. Pretty surprising to a lot of people that aren't Mormon. But if you're Mormon, you're like, oh, I can see that.
Oh, so you're a Mormon.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So is that in the... see, that's interesting.
Do all Mormons hold on to it that long?
Yeah.
We try to. Well, not that long. In fact, see, when I was on my... I served a Mormon mission to Michigan.
Yeah.
And when I was on my mission, I was like, oh, I'm going to be married by the time I'm 24. And then when I was 24 and I wasn't married, I'm like, okay, 27. Like, 27's the latest. And then I hit 27. I'm like, crap, I'm still not married. And then I hit 30, and I'm like, okay, if I'm 30 and not married, that's like the magic bullet age. That's like gun in my mouth kind of thing. I'm like, holy crap, I'm 30 and not married. What's wrong with me? And now I'm 34, and now I'm looking and going like, okay, so.
Well, I would think at this point, it's like I've gone this far. I might as well just keep going and see how long I can go.
Yeah. Never give it away.
It's not just that. It's, you know, I mean, like the ideal, the goal of any devout Mormon is to be able to get married in the temple. So you want to be as righteous as you can so that you can get married there. And ideally, you know, and not everyone does it, and that's cool, whatever, you know, people fall. Like in the Mormon church, we look at it as the most important thing to God is his kids, which is all of us. So the most important thing to us should be our families, too.
Yeah, but Skippy, being a Mormon, do you have to stay? Like, because you live with your parents still, right?
You don't have to live in your parents' basement if you're a Mormon. No, I fell on hard times financially, you know? And so, like, if I could afford to live on my own, I would... Trust me, it would be very helpful for my social life.
No, but dude, you see, we went to your YouTube page. We're checking out. You do some stand-up and all that stuff, but I was wondering if this was a shtick or not.
No, you know, I've had people say that, like, oh, it's part... No. I mean, like, I could show you the bills of, you know, the money that I owe to creditors.
I'm talking about your virginity and stuff. I mean, how does a comic not... How could you not go off stage and get laid?
If you get on stage, you would think you'd be charming enough to, like, get some chick's pants off.
Oh, yeah. No, I can get girls. I've come close to third base, but I spot myself.
What's third base?
You know.
Okay, so first is kissing. Second is touching mommy daddy parts, and then third base is orally touching mommy daddy parts, and then fourth base is home. Right?
I guess. So I you stopped a girl from doing the third base?
I've been in the process of third base and then stopped it from going further.
See, man, you have some good...
you got good breaks.
Yeah, because even if I came close to that with a guy, I'd have a tough time stopping.
Yeah, the movie Unstoppable could be that. It could be the movie of my... Yeah.
Wow. Wow. I thought it was an interesting show. It's a great idea that they do on this show. It's TLC.
Yeah.
What is it, Tuesday night?
It's on Wednesday night.
Oh, okay, because I have my TiVo set because they replay it a lot, and I haven't seen the Skippy episode yet, but it's interesting watching this dude because he just sits at home and makes silly T-shirts and in his mom's basement.
So he's just waiting to marry a chick, right? That's what it is?
Yeah, that's the Mormon way. I you know what the thing is, it used to be like the show, like the Jersey, this is all the opposite of Jersey Shore. The Jersey Shore is about drinking and getting laid. And then you have these shows, which is the people that don't do anything. Do you realize once you take advantage of you being on TV and get laid, you're finished?
That's what they say. And my thought is like, okay, if I really do... live my life to this way that I want to, then I'm hoping that I can stay away from the kind of people that would, you know, have those kind of intents and designs. And it's been funny. I mean, just the show aired last Wednesday night, and then by Friday I had like 450 Twitter followers, but now I've got 850 Twitter followers, and I had about 2,000 friends, and now I've got 2,200 friends on Facebook. And so I've gotten just like, and I kind of felt like I exploded a little bit on the...
Speaking of the internet, do you pleasure yourself?
You know what? See, even as you ask me this question, I'll give you the answer. But these in the Mormon church are what we call bishop interview questions, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, like, this is the kind of thing that I would go talk to my bishop about whether or not.
Well, I'm asking if you beat your bishop.
Yeah. Okay. And if I'm being honest, yeah, I've done that.
Yeah.
But I'll also tell you that I was 26 the very first time I did that.
Oh, my gosh.
I was able to go 26 years without ever having done that.
Did you put a hole in the ceiling down there? Your mom's kitchen floor?
The cleanup was a wreck.
No, it wasn't quite that bad, but it was one of those things where even I was surprised. I'm like, I can't believe it.
Dude, I started late, and I was in my teens.
Do you have like an age? I mean, obviously, what's he, 36 now?
Yeah.
So, I mean, do you have an age going past this that you're saying, I'm just going to go ahead and do it if I don't find a wife?
Yeah, at what point do you just become a bishop?
I mean this as sincerely as I can. My goal is to not get have sex until I get married in a Mormon temple. And so I'm going to wait. You know, I mean, even if it means heaven forbid I'm 42 and single. I mean,
wow.
It doesn't matter.
Dude, once you dive in the first time, you're going to be like, why? F this, all that stuff. You're going to be like, why did I wait?
Because I'm going to tell you right now.
I'm going to be with my wife when that happens.
It's not going to be better when it's with your wife, though. It's going to be the same.
Yeah.
I don't know yet.
Tell you.
Hey, there's another episode I watch online where it's like these two people that were waiting. They're married. You know, they get married.
Oh, yeah. Never kissed. No, I kissed. In fact, you see me kiss the 40th girl that I get a make out with is on my episode.
Right, but those other people that they got married.
It was awkward.
Yeah, and they started making out, and it was their teeth were clanking and all. It was awful.
Didn't they look like they were on bath salts and they were clanking on each other's faces?
Yes.
Yeah. No, it's true. Ryan and Shanna, God bless them for being the first to navigate the waters of virginity, virgin diaries, because it would be tough to be them and have that get shown to everyone the rest of their lives.
Hey, Skippy, I got to move, but what is your website and stuff?
IamSkippy.com. Follow me on Twitter at IamSkippy. I've got a YouTube channel and... you know what, guys? If things go well with this, there's a chance that I might get my own reality TV show out of it.
Well, let's hope. I'm hoping that you get laid and stuff. But I appreciate you coming on, man. It's Skippy. The show is called TLC Virgin Diaries. It was a pretty interesting idea, and I'm going to be hooked on this show, I'm sure, because you just get shocked at what goes on.
I'm amazed already.
I have our secret celebrity we're going to be talking to here in a few minutes, all right? And a chance for you to get Uproar tickets. All last week, we qualified people to go up on the drum riser, the drum set with Tommy Lee during his solo, and we finally picked the name. And who is this on the phone?
This is Renee.
Renee,
what?
Yes.
Dude, Renee, you're gonna be riding on Tommy Lee's drum set.
Serious?
Are you married?
I am.
All right, leave him at home because we wanted you to get that drumstick too, if you know what I mean.
Get it, girl.
Oh my God, yeah. He's staying at home with the kids because I am freaking out right now. This is awesome. So, I've gone every year to this show. Oh my God.
So if Tommy Lee said, "Hey, let's go hook up," you would do it?
No. I get some sugar.
That's it? Sugar's weak.
Are y'all serious?
Yes.
I feel like I'm being punked.
No, you're not being punked. This is for real.
Exciting. She's fired up.
Yeah.
I'm so excited.
Congratulations.
Oh my kids and I, we all dress up even like his kids.
Okay.
All right. Halloween.
It's getting okay, weird. You're getting weird.
It's getting weird.
I know. Yeah, this is amazing.
So
this
you're telling me, like, if my wife came home and said, "Hey, we're gonna be going on this thing with Tommy Lee," I'd be like concerned.
Yeah.
Yeah. He may be a little concerned. You know, we did see the video.
He could drive with his Schween, his boat.
Oh my God! I cannot believe this. This is awesome. You guys rock.
Nice. Look, lady, all we did was pull the name. I had nothing to do with this.
Somebody take the credit. This is amazing. I'm so excited. You've made a great Monday. A great year.
Okay. All right, hold on 1 second. We're going to get your info, and you're going to be riding on the drum set, all right?
Oh, my gosh. I can't wait to meet all y'all tomorrow then.
All right, very good.
Thank you.
Yes, hold on. Very fired up, that chick. That's tomorrow night. What a big show that is, too. What a rock show. Kiss and Motley Crue. Looks cute. Thomas, we have a secret celebrity on the phone. Go ahead, give the clues. If you guess these clues, or if you guess who it is with these clues before we talk to this person, I will give you Warped Tour ticks, all right?
So the first clue is his brother never knew what he was talking about. And the second clue is this guy moved to the beat of more than just one drum.
All right, that's those are your clues. Let's go over here and get a guess. Run, are you there?
Yeah, buddy, what's up?
What's your guess for Secret Celebrity?
Gary Coleman.
No, unfortunately, he's dead, so we won't be talking to him.
What a dummy.
Dude, what's wrong with you?
Are you serious?
Sweet.
Sweet. Let's go. Cameron, do you have a guess for our Secret Celebrity?
Is it Todd Bridges?
Thomas?
Yes, it's Todd Bridges!
Finally! Todd Bridges, what's up, brother?
What's up, Atlanta?
Hey, dude, you ever get here?
I used to. That's where my ex-wife was from.
Oh, okay. Oh, sorry.
Come there all the time. Oh, okay.
Did you get remarried?
No. Yes. Put that on me. Why you trying to put that on me?
Never, ever again, right?
Exactly. That was my second one.
It was so that bad?
That was your second one.
Yeah, it's just that I just don't want to be there again.
Right. No, I'm with you. I'm married now, 5 years, but will I ever get married again? No.
Yeah, I went through it twice, and that's good enough for me.
Yeah. Which one was the roughest?
Second one.
Really?
It was the longest.
Oh, yeah.
15 years.
See, now during it, don't you start to think, man, why did I make money? You know what I mean?
Well, yeah. Because in California, we all lose.
Yeah, exactly.
Men lose bad.
I know. Isn't it? I mean, that's the thing where it's like, okay, right before you you serve somebody with divorce papers, you just move to Denver or something real quick.
Or Atlanta. Atlanta actually has a good system.
Yeah. You looked into all of it, huh?
Yes, I have, sir.
Hey, Todd, do you remember one time we had one of our guys go out and interview at one of those comic conventions?
It was like a monster.
Oh, yeah, and he went nuts on me, that guy. Yeah. That chased out.
Yeah.
You remember that?
Yeah, he grabbed
I remember that guy.
Or you grabbed him and you almost beat his ass.
Yeah, he said something about being something about drugs and crackhead and something about my mom.
Yeah, he was our old phone screener. This is the tape right here.
Todd Bridges, how you doing?
I'm doing pretty good today.
Great. Chiller Festival, how's it treating you?
Treating me really well and having a great time.
Where were you when Arnold and Doodley got touched within the bike shop?
Doodley? I don't know. I was gone.
Did you ever burn some coal with some white women?
Why are you asking crazy questions, man?
Is Fergie's song about bridges falling down about your career?
About your mama, bitch.
Did you ever have a white woman work off her drug debts?
Yeah, she was your hoe. Your mama.
That's interesting. Did you sell Dana Plato bad crack?
No, we sold your mama crack, bitch.
It's funny because I really don't think your mama jokes are very that creative.
I don't really think that you're very that creative either.
All right, well, I mean, I guess... What are you doing there, sir? Sir, why are you ripping up my questions? Thank you very much, Todd Bridges. Yeah, you don't...
You think it's funny, dude? It's not funny.
I thought it was kind of funny.
It's not funny. And you're still hurt doing that.
Well, Todd Bridges is touching me right now. I think it's... Nope, sir. Sir. Todd.
You want to start it? We're done. We're not done. If you
touch me, I'll sue you, sir.
You can sue me all you want. You're an idiot.
All right.
And you're going to be thrown out of here. You're not coming back.
Okay.
You didn't realize Willis was a little bit nuts, right? You better back off, Willis.
Dude, that's amazing that you're 20 years sober. Congratulations on that, by the way.
Thank you, bro. Dude. I'm going 20 years sober. It'll be next year, February 24th. I'll be
wow.
Does
do you, I'm 19 and a half.
Do you ever, like, is there ever any temptation around you at all anymore?
Nah, dude. I don't even want to go that direction. That is just not for me, bro.
Yeah, right. He's been sober so long, too, that, there's no one around you that's going to have
right,
any.
Yeah.
No. Now, are you kidding me? I would get rid of that person so quick if they were around me doing some crazy stuff. I went to a party and saw that mess, and I was like, man, I'll see y'all later. I'm going home.
Oh,
man,
really?
I'm not into that anymore. I'm not into ruining my life.
Right, no.
You know what I mean?
That's what sucks about Hollywood is that stuff's around everywhere.
Yeah, you can't escape it.
It's not really, dude. It's not really. Not really as much as you think it is. It's not really.
Huh.
Now, Hollywood is kind of like taking an ugly face to it. Now, thing about it is, you got to realize it's more the American public who's more accepting of it. Because I give a good example is they don't care about Lindsay Lohan.
Right,
they go see her movies. They don't care about Charlie Sheen.
So you're telling me Charlie Sheen does drugs?
Come on, we saw it, man. We all did. I ain't even got to tell you that one. We saw that. And when you can see him when he was talking, he's like, man, this dude's gone, dude. He smoked out.
Chris, you'll like this. When Todd was on the Celebrity Championship Wrestling,
yes,
he went under the name Mr. Not-So-Perfect.
That's right. Hey, I had to, because you know what I mean? Because that's what I was. And actually, I did a great job on that show. That was a fun show, man.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, man, after that show, I give so many props to wrestlers, man.
Of course.
Man, dude, that is a lot of work, man, and it hurts.
Todd, please tell me that you beat that little weenie Dustin Diamond.
Yeah, I whooped his butt. He was pissed.
Dustin Diamond, he allegedly had that porno come out a couple years ago where he's packing. You think that's real?
Man, he does a lot of stuff for attention. Have you noticed that?
Yep.
And I don't do that, man. I'm not going to do stuff for seeking attention, you know. I'm not doing something like that. I got kids, man. I'm not going to embarrass my kids like that.
Did you like hanging out with that guy, or did you just like do?
No, he was nobody wanted to hang out with him. He was always complaining.
It's hard to believe that a weenie that played a weenie could be such a diva, right?
Right. Yeah.
I know. Yes, I mean, you've seen him on all those shows.
Yeah.
He always ends up with everybody hating him. Have you ever noticed that?
Yeah, he does.
At the end of the show, nobody likes him. It's just the craziest thing in the world. It's like, dude, that personality at the end of the show, all the people are like, man, I can't stand that dude.
Yeah.
You know, and I like him, but I'm not hanging around him.
Yeah, right.
I hope you bitch slap his ass.
I don't dislike anybody. Yeah. I've learned that lesson. You don't dislike people. But I got something good for you guys, really good for you guys, man. You know, and, you know, we're talking about puppies and kittens, you know, a new leash on life. Great place, man. And it's a...
What?
Place where they actually retrain dogs to be adopted. You know, who doesn't have a dog or a cat? You see what I'm saying? Now, check this out. If you call this number, not only will they donate money.
What is this?
This is pitch thing he's got to do.
Oh, he has to do this?
Well, that's the kind of thing to get him on.
Oh, for Secret Celebrity?
Yeah, he wanted to talk
about. Oh, was he busy?
Cruise to the Bahamas. Everything is paid for except for.
Yeah, so I don't know what the.
You got to pay that.
Just let him go.
Great cabin. Delicious meals. They got a restaurant in there. Like,
but how about this? Hold on. There's a chick on the phone. I want to get naked for us.
Live Las Vegas entertainment. Sweet. Music. You know, activities for
hey, Miss Whitney.
Family,
yes.
Hi.
That goes Hi.
Just ignore Todd doing there. He's done. Go ahead. What's up?
Not much.
My purpose for doing this.
So you're the Twitter. She was supposed to come in and be the Twitter chick in a month, local girl. And she was going to get naked for us. But she blew us off.
So, I did not blow you
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. You ruined it. And so now she wants to make it up for us, Thomas.
Yeah, I tried to get a hold of you several times.
Yeah.
I'm a busy girl.
Yeah. So how are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? Are we gonna get you to come in and do something like in the studio to earn a?
I can do that.
Okay. Because Thomas, I'm thinking. Hold on a minute.
This is what's in my heart right now. You know, it's out of my heart to really get.
That's Todd Bridges. What I'm thinking is have her come in and do the topless seal.
Oh yeah.
Here in the studio. Can I explain this to you?
Yes, please do.
Topless seal is we have this apparatus set up in front of you. You're on your knees in front of it, and it's got horns on it. Mm-hmm. Okay. And you're topless. And we have candy fish. And what we do is when we ring a bell, you arf like a seal and clap your hands. And then you honk the horn with your nose and we feed you candy fish.
What do you say?
Oh, so you guys want to humiliate me?
That's not humiliating. You're a very beautiful girl.
Are you saying being a seal is humiliating?
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, we're not going to club you.
Yeah. We'll make sure Greenpeace is outside.
Yeah, it's either do that or I'm going to make you sit here and listen to Todd Bridges.
Okay.
So you're going to do it?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Oh, yes!
You know, they got koozies, man. They got, glass and case food on decks. They got club darts.
That's Todd Bridges. All right, hold on, okay? All right, you heard it, Thomas. At 7:40 a.m. on Monday, she committed to it, okay?
Yeah, let's work this out then.
Right. All right.
You know, that will help somebody who maybe really needs an animal or if you just want to help donate to animals.
So anyhow, I wanted to tell you that we have our...
Dude.
We are going on a nice cruise, Thomas, on Lake Lanier.
That's
Bud
right.
Light party boat coming up on August 4th. Go to kidchris.com, keyword Facebook, and you'll see the link up there to our event. We want you to sign up and join us, tip a few back with us, and have a good time. It's a whole afternoon. It's going to be good on August 4th, okay?
See, the new Lucha Life Booker, and all the rest of them, they retrain them. So if they have bad habits, they retrain them for good habits. You're getting a
Let's check
dog.
Traffic.
You get a dog that's ready to go. You know what I mean? And the new Lucha Life program, man, really helps people,
It's Todd Bridges, Thomas, telling us about this dog thing.
Retrain them and make them even better, and there's puppies there. I mean, there's everything there, man, and who don't want to help out?
I'm looking up here at the the Bud Light party boat invite. If you go to kidchris.com, keyword Facebook, you'll see it up there. You just go and you can click on it and log in and be a part of this thing. It's going to be a good time. So it's going to be us out there on Lake Lanier on a boat all day, just tipping them back in the sun. That's going to be a good time. We did it last year, too. We were just a few weeks old, it seemed.
Yeah, it was very new.
So that's up there for you, okay? That's coming up on August 4th. So if you got nothing going on that day, mark it down. Put in your calendar and hang out with us. I have at 9 o'clock a chance for you to get your tickets for Uproar Tour. That's a good one. Shinedown, Godsmack, Stain, Papa Roach, Lakewood Amphitheater, September 12th. That's 9, 2, and 5 all this week. So that's a pretty good prize. You want to do some Wolfpack? I got new Wolfpack stuff. These guys calling radio shows. And, I got involved with this one, Thomas.
Did you? Did you start to dabble a little bit?
Yeah, I dabbled in this one. You want to hear these?
Yeah, I like it when you call because you always
I haven't done it in so long.
You have the worst. You think I have bad voices. You have the worst
voice. I use
voices.
The same one.
No, you do like, you do I'm scared, nerdy guy.
Yeah, that's the one I use.
Yeah.
Hey. I haven't done prank calls like this in a long time because I don't have to. Because, the Zimmerman and those guys do it.
Yeah, it's good to see you get into it every once in a while, though. It is fun.
So we were here late one afternoon. We decided to start calling shows.
You're live with Todd Train the Buzz. Go ahead.
Hey, I am leaving your...
It's hilarious to me, the whole Patrick yelling at Allie about us and then using that clip to call radio shows. That is hilarious.
You're live with Todd Train the Buzz. Go ahead.
Hey, I am leaving your radio station.
Uh-huh.
If he says my name or anything or plays my commercials or my songs, I will get an attorney and I will sue you guys' ass.
All right, thanks for the call.
All right.
What was that? I don't speak Greek.
Neither do I.
I don't know what that was all about.
That was weird. That might have been the onset of rantings.
Let's try it again. You're on live with Todd Train the Buzz. Go ahead.
All right. And tell my friend his wife is a home.
You're on live with Todd Train the Buzz. Go ahead.
I want you to write this down.
Okay, hold on.
Go ahead.
Let me get a pen. All right, go.
Hey, I am leaving your radio station.
Okay.
Please say my name or anything, or place my commercials or my songs. I will get an attorney and I will sue you guys' ass.
Okay, that's a recording. He's just playing that over. Thanks for the call.
Uh-huh.
That's a recording. Did you hear that? He's doing it. He's just calling up and playing a recording over and over again. That was the same thing.
Wow, he busted him.
Yeah, geniuses.
He figured it out.
That's a recording.
Crack the code.
Fascinating.
Has that worked one time?
The first three times.
Yeah.
Sounded like that one person. Right. That's what he sounded like.
And the funny part about that.
Person.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what they're talking about. I just think
they're
it's
talking
funny.
In code to themselves now.
Yeah. This is the Wolfpack and with featuring me.
Is the economic policy matches the telephone prank policy. Complete failure. It don't work.
Mm.
Go to the phones, 823-1920. You're on live with Todd Train the Buzz. Go ahead.
Hey, guys. Did you...
The easiest call, the easiest show to prank, and I blow it.
Go to the phones, 823-1920. You're on live with Todd Train the Buzz. Go ahead.
Hey, guys. Did you hear the story about Chick-fil-A?
Chick-fil-A?
Go ahead.
Do you know what that is?
Isn't it a chicken joint?
Okay, thanks for the call.
What did you do?
What did you do?
Because I realized, because the show.
Did you panic?
The show, I didn't think that they had Chick-fil-A in
Chick-fil-A's
California.
Chick-fil-A's everywhere.
Yeah. Not in New York. They don't have Chick-fil-A's in New York.
Chick-fil-A's, everybody knows about Chick-fil-A.
Yeah. Well, the guy goes, isn't that a chicken joint?
Yeah.
Yeah, so he knew what it was.
So continue.
And then you froze.
Hey.
You should just put more Patrick tapes.
Yeah, right. That's funny, dude. Hey.
I just start laughing.
Hey, guys, hear the story about Chick-fil-A?
Chick-fil-A?
Go ahead.
Do you know what that is?
Isn't it a chicken joint?
Right there, I fail.
What?
Okay, thanks for the call.
They're waiting,
you have to be
so
brave.
They want to know.
You really do. If you're going to call and do it, do it.
I mean,
it.
If you've got the if you've got the talent, that's one thing.
Mm-hmm.
But if you don't have it's down here.
You,
yeah, that.
You don't have the these guys. These clowns called you out. You should hang it up.
How many times did we sit there and listen to this, Dubs? That was hilarious.
Yes, many times.
Testinal fortitude.
Oh, okay. I was going lower.
No, it's the same.
823-1920. You're on Live with Tantra and the Buzz. Go ahead.
So anyways, about Chick-fil-A.
You called back.
I'm redeeming myself, Thomas, please.
You're on Live with Tantra and the Buzz. Go ahead.
Those guys, they said that they don't support gay marriage, but I find it odd because they sell cock.
Get it? All right, thanks for the call.
Get it?
Where are you going? What?
Well, it's because we got in his face and said he couldn't do it, so he got a little braver. That's the influence we have on people.
It took him long enough to get to it, and he was like,
"Yeah, I can try it down the phone."
You know what's hilarious about this is while we were listening to this, because Williams was in there with us, we were
giggling.
All everything they were saying was true. They're like, "Oh yeah, they're sitting around giggling and stuff." Yeah. We're like, "Yes!" It's so awkward.
Got him. Oh, boy. Well, it's summer, so all the teenagers are out there pulling this. It's great. I like the fact that we got 823.
I'm 38 years old.
I've been a teenager in 20 years.
But I got excited.
1920. You're on Live with Todd and Trent the Buzz. Go ahead.
Hey, did you guys hear about the mayor?
Thanks for calling.
That
was him again. That's him.
Was it?
Yeah, that's him again.
Oh, God, I am dying over
that
here.
That voice, yours.
Hey. Well, Williams goes, what do you do next? Call up about the mayor of Party City?
I'm like, and of course you did.
Of course.
Hey. Hear about the mayor
thanks
of
for calling.
Party City.
Yeah.
No, wait.
That was him again. That's him.
Was him?
Yeah, that's him again. Next call, 823-1920. You're on Live with Todd Trey on the Buzz. Don't try it.
Yeah, because that guy called back. I want to hear about the mayor of Party City.
Thanks for the call.
Nice.
That wasn't him.
No, it was his brother.
Don't encourage him.
No.
823-1920, you're on Live with Tantra and the Buzz. Go ahead.
Yeah, I heard that guy, you wanted to hear about the mayor of Party City.
Yeah, thanks for the call.
No, you don't want to hear about it?
Yeah. Not right now.
Thank you.
Nice.
Oh, what a train wreck. They got the last laugh on us. On me.
I like the
it's funny.
I like Doug calling and leading you to the end, you know, helping you out a little bit.
My head hurts. That is hilarious.
Dude, the Chick-fil-A call. The chicken joint. Click. What?
Isn't that the chicken joint? I'm like, oh, they don't know what it is.
Confirm the fact that it's a chicken joint for you.
I know. It's hilarious.
You're a loser.
And the only thing anybody needs
I should
needs
have yelled boner and hung up, huh, Thomas?
Oh, really?
The only thing.
Yo, penis 80 times.
Please do. The only thing that anybody needed to know, it was a chicken place, because that is the joke.
That's the joke.
Yeah.
And I bailed. They gave me the alley-oop, and I just stood there and watched the ball.
You just kicked the ball out of there.
That's hilarious. Perfect.
Got something to say, but the show ain't on? Call the Kid Chris Show after hours line at 404-870-5115.
Kid Chris. What's up, mama? Yo, check it out, Chris. I've been listening to the podcast and talking about your sleep apnea mask. You say there's no cure for it. Of course there's a cure for sleep apnea. Stop being a fat hedgehog, yo. If you wasn't so fat, you'd be able to breathe better. Jerk
dick.
Off.
What a dick. After hours line.
Hello, George. I'm calling because I'm wondering if you've ever seen a midget naked. You know, I don't believe this is Ricardo Montalban.
Calling Mr. Sulu.
Hello.
Hi, George. This is Ricardo Montalban.
Ricardo?
Yes.
How are you?
How are you?
Just great.
I was just calling to say hello.
Well, it's always delightful to hear from you.
Aha. Uh-huh. So, what are you doing this evening?
Well, believe it or not, tomorrow I'm taking off on a Star Trek cruise. We have Star Trek conventions that now float.
Aha. Are you going to come out to Fantasy Island?
Well, we're sailing from San Pedro, and we're going through the Panama Canal.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Is there any,
what are you up to?
I don't. I'm just driving around with talking on my new phone.
Oh. Well, good for you.
Yes, I was thinking about hooking, trying to buy some hookers.
Oh my!
Is that your doggy?
That's my dog.
What's your dog's name?
She's a papillon. Her name is Ren.
Ren?
You speak French?
Very little.
Well, Ren means queen.
Aha! Uh-huh. I know Ren and Stimpy.
Oh no! Not that Ren. R-E-I-N-E.
I see.
Ren.
Aha. Uh-huh.
La Reine, her full name is La Reine Blanche.
Aha, that's a pretty...
Elena Blanca.
That's a pretty name.
Thank you.
Have you, have you been watching E! When they had the story about Tattoo?
No.
Oh, that's why I'm calling. I was wondering if you ever seen a midget naked.
You know, I don't think you're Ricardo Montalban.
That's Mr. Sulu. It took you that long, huh, to figure out that it wasn't Ricardo. Ricardo!
It was good. You had a good one going.
Oh, yeah. My awful impression seemed to work with everybody.
Except the people you're around, right?
Exactly. Yeah. No one around me thinks it's real, but everybody else, hey, that's all that matters.
That's where it counts, though, right?
Yeah. Yeah, getting Rodney Dangerfield on the phone, thinking it's Louis Anderson, Mr. Sulu, thinking it's Ricardo Montalban. And then he became our friend for a while. And then the epic song using the clips. You know, here's the story behind that is when I was a disc jockey, I didn't have any celebrity phone numbers. Like when I was a nighttime DJ, so I would just call and harass Mr. Sulu all the time. It's the only fun I ever had. I mean, he sounds like a robot when he answers the phone. Hello, how are you? And then, you know, like with this show, typical, we just take one little thing and then use it in different ways. So,
beat it to death.
Yeah, then it became this. S-S-S-S-U-U. Hit the Sulu dance.
Sulu dance. You can dance like Sulu.
Hello.
And shake your little behind.
Yes.
You gotta give it a chance when you do the Sulu dance and your friends will say.
Oh my.
Say, jump around if you want to. And move your arms like a machine.
Yes.
If you do the Zulu dance while wearing tight pants, some people may call you a
queen.
The Zulu dance.
Zulu, Zulu, just fine. Zulu, Zulu. Now that's ridiculous.
Zulu dance is fun to do.
Well,
but your girl may get jealous.
No.
Cause if you abuse it, your girl will lose it and run up and say,
who is this?
You can dance like Sulu,
you know,
but some may choose to not.
No.
You gotta give it a chance when you do the Sulu dance, and your girl will give up the
balloon nod.
Sulu dance.
Balloon nod.
Sulu dance.
Yes.
What you say when you answer the phone.
Hello.
Sulu dance.
Yes.
Sulu dance.
Yes.
I wanna dance, we're having a ball.
Thank you very much.
Sulu dance.
Yes.
Sulu dance.
Yes.
Everybody will sing and laugh. Sulu dance.
Yes.
Sulu dance.
Yes.
Shake that big bulge in your pants.
No.
Pants.
Thank you.
It's a Sulu dance.
You know.
It's a Sulu dance.
Thank you.
Do the Sulu dance.
Oh my.
It's a Sulu dance.
Yes.
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 It's a Sulu dance.
Now that's ridiculous.
I see Zimmerman from the Wolfpacks on the phone.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, this is going to be good.
Hey guys. Nice Wolfpack call, loser.
I don't know, I got to pick myself up off the ground after that one.
Did you handle that call like Dubs handle singing live in the studio?
You got a point. A little bit.
Really? That's what we're doing? This is what we're going to do.
Is Zimmerman there? I'd rather talk to Todd Bridges again.
All right. Hey, you just got hung out to dry.
Buddy, it's a big smash hit.
Huge.
Oh, yuck.
I work for Darth Vader. I am a bounty hunter. Not after Skywalker. Now onto Cloud City. Lando played both sides. Solos in Carbonite. Don't need the Wookiee. Jabba, we're on our way. Leia's tears are flowing. C-3PO is broken. In Carbonite, he's frozen. So sad, it's Chewie. I'm
Boba Fett dude. And Jabba hired me. So here's Han Solo. So freaking pay me. I'm Boba Fett dude.
Don't laugh.
What a loser.
Threw me off.
You ruined it.
I ruined it.
You ruined it.
Such poetry.
It was written well.
Hey, I'm Boba Fett, dude. Oh, Thomas, some nice feedback on the after hours line.
Thomas, remembering how excited you got when Michaela told you to do 10 in the news, I bet you're just giddy fantasizing about being up on the stage at the Motley Crue show riding Tommy Lee's big rig. Yeah. You dirt-blowing bastard.
Yeah, people seem to forget this tape.
Put a tan later. I already went to the gym.
Oh, that's cool. Do you do like a full naked or do you wear like a bikini?
This is Thomas and Michaela the tranny talking.
This is
she recorded him.
You made this.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. Do you do like a
I did my best Thomas impression.
Full naked or do you wear like a bikini?
I do naked. Why?
Oh, really? But that's cool, though. You never know who could walk in or, you know, who might get a picture of you in there.
Who's not to say who invited me or I invited in with me?
Oh, you invite people in?
After hours? Yeah.
You do it? You hook up with people in the tanning bed?
Yeah, I've done the funky monkey before.
That's hot.
Ooh, that's hot. Well, Brittany intern.
Thomas, you're so gay.
Thomas
is a yellow Japanese. Yellow Japanese. Yellow Japanese. Thomas is a yellow Japanese.
That's hot.
Yellow Japanese. Yellow Japanese.
My chinky friends own liquor stores and leave their shoes by the front door. Ching Chang Chu and Moshi Moshi.
That's hot.
Yeah, it's hot. Do it.
Thomas is a yellow Japanese.
That's
yellow Japanese. Yellow Japanese.
Patrick, you're on the air.
Hey, Kid Chris, have you ever had a vagina?
Okay.
Yellow Japanese. Yellow
he said
Japanese.
He had a joke, but I'm not doing it. Well, there you go. That's Thomas had a brand new song that he performed right here on our show. That video,
good.
Yeah. If you go to kidchris.com, you'll be able to watch that video up there of Thomas performing. And it's funny watching him because he gets all rock starish and all that. It's kind of like Britney did in her song.
Oh, yeah. She put it on. But, you know, but she's a performer as well, so she understands.
Britney's breasts don't jiggle as much as Thomas is doing that song.
She was packing this much.
Another Wolfpack Media assault.
I hear some more Wolfpack stuff.
Call next year on the Radio Shopping Show. Hello.
I get the Tropicana Resort.
Okay, we'll go ahead and put one of those down there for you.
Can I bring Kid Chris with me?
And let's go to your phone call next.
What?
There's some guy called and tried to make a prank and he started giggling.
Couldn't hang on to it.
Which makes it funnier.
Yeah, I'm calling about the spaghetti factory stuff.
The spaghetti warehouse?
Yeah, I wanted to see if I can get any tickets to that.
They are not with the program right now.
Oh, they're not? Will they be serving any of Kid Chris's meat whistle there?
Do you know who Kid Chris is?
Do you?
No, I don't. That's why I'm asking you.
Well, he wants to serve you some meat.
Yeah, well, okay. Let's go to your phone call next.
My tag number is stuck to Kid Chris's taint.
Okay, Kid Chris again, huh?
The Kid Chris Show. Mornings on Project 961.
Yeah! 9215, we got tickets for you coming up with Allie here in a little while. We'll get you hands on Uproar Tour, 9215. And also, you know, Allie's so sweet, it's her birthday today and she's giving out gifts.
What?
So generous. Yep. She's what? She's 22?
I think she just turned 22.
Yeah. 23. 404-741-9696 is our phone number. Tomorrow is the big show with Kiss and Motley Crue. Of course, we had a nice chat with Gene Simmons from Kiss when we announced the show. Those guys are marketing geniuses.
Hi, Chris. It's Gene Simmons.
From
Kiss.
Yeah. Oh, man. That's great.
It's going to be the greatest rock show of all time. Tickets are available at kissonline.com. We're going to be selling mints at the show. We're going to be selling T-shirts, tour programs. We're going to be selling shoehorns. We're going to be selling hair plugs, Kiss makeup. You go to the Kiss concert, and also go to kissonline.com for any other information you need.
Wow, look at that. It's a plethora. It's like a buffet of Kiss material.
Who's the number one band in rotation? I'll answer it for you. It's Kiss. The number one band of all time. And we're inviting everyone who's going to see Kiss live after the show. You're going to get a copy of Kiss My Laughs. All of our favorite jokes. This is breaking news, Chris. I'm giving this to you as an exclusive.
Wow, so it's a book of jokes?
This is the announcement. Are you ready for this?
Sure.
Knock knock.
Who's there?
Lettuce.
Lettuce who?
Lettuce in. We're Kiss. How about this? Knock knock.
Who's there?
Orange.
Orange who?
Orange, you glad it's Kiss that just charged you $200?
Hey, what's the name of this book?
It's called Kiss My Laughs. Here, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Boo.
Boo-hoo.
Why are you crying? It was Kiss that just raped you.
Oh, man, these are great.
Yeah. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Ketchup. Catch up with Kiss on kissonline.com. Isn't that amazing?
Oh, man. Gee, this is why Kiss is the biggest, most electrifying band ever.
You're absolutely right. And one more thing I want to say to you, Chris.
Yes.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Gene.
Gene who?
Gene Simmons from Kiss. Isn't that unbelievable?
Oh, man, that
so
is
go
crazy.
To the concert. I'll be honest with you. What you get when you come in the door is you get a leaflet. The leaflet is Kiss My Laughs. It's a sample of the greatest joke writing. And then you go to kissonline.com and you get the actual book.
Man, this
but
is...
I got to go. And this has all been brought to you by kissonline.com. We're not trying to plug. I'm just telling you the truth.
Okay. Well, thank you. Thanks, Gene.
All right. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Of course, that's tomorrow night. Big show. Motley Crue and Kiss. Get your Kiss My Laughs bank, like little pamphlet.
I'm getting one.
Jonathan, what's up?
Hey.
Oh, hey, Jonathan.
I just went to the 311 concert and some crazy things happened.
Well, hold on. Let's try it. Okay, you went to the 311 concert and a couple things happened. Is that what you said?
Crazy.
Yeah. Oh,
okay.
Well, it was great, but 311 was crazy because the people were smoking weed.
Really? Where, did you smoke weed, Jonathan?
No.
Okay.
I would not do such a thing like that. They're stupid.
They're stupid for smoking weed out there?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you have good seats?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, who'd you go with?
My mom.
Okay.
Poor mom.
Yeah. Did your mom smoke weed while she was out there?
No.
No. Do you think she has in the past?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Okay. I don't believe you. I think she has. I wouldn't believe her.
You gotta be kidding me, man.
No, I'm not.
What?
How old's your mom?
40.
40?
Oh.
Yeah, she's smoked
tasted
pot.
It before.
Yeah, if she smoked
43.
Pot. How old?
43.
43? Yeah, if she smoked. Is she there right now?
Hmm?
Is she there right now?
She's sleeping.
Of course, because she's high. She smokes pot. No, look, trust me, she has.
I mean, doesn't do drugs.
Drugs.
No, she may have in the past.
Yeah, in the past. We're not talking about now. I don't know if she does now.
Shut up. She doesn't do drugs.
You shut up.
Period. She doesn't do drugs.
He's getting mad.
He's getting uncomfortable.
Bye.
Bye. You know what? I like him now. I like him now.
That dude's autistic, right? That's what we found out. I don't know. That's not a, you have like a, I don't know, mongoloid, whatever that is. And then you have.
Connie's more mongoloid.
Right. Constantine, right.
Yeah,
he's got a large head and he's, got a few extra chromosomes piled on a pile there.
Yeah.
Then you have autism, which we have Wendy, Wolfpack Wendy's got autism.
Right.
We call it awesome-tism. Then you have Jonathan. Who's definitely got awesome-tism.
Definitely. He's got a healthy amount.
It's a good
amount.
One. Yeah. No, I like it. Here's, and by the way, I got this off the newsfeed thing. You got the YouTube where everybody's a star on there, they could put up their stuff, but it's very hard to go through and sift through all the crap to find the talent. This guy went up there and is singing a cappella, all the parts, you'll like this, Thomas, in the Indiana Jones theme.
That's cool.
You have to be autistic to put this together. You sit and listen to that like while you sleep?
Yeah.
I mean, that sounds awesome.
Skipping through the Temple of Doom.
Yeah. Here's a guy that's in trouble for a store name that he has, Thomas.
The name is Orange County Master Bait Shop. People are taking the master and also the bait shop and combining them together into a word that's not actually spelt on our business name. That's the name that we chose, and that's the name that we want to stick with. The only bait shop that makes their own chicken livers. We produce our own worms. We package our own worms. And that's what we do. That's why we're a master bait shop.
Yeah. You didn't come up with that at all?
You didn't think at all?
Yeah, you didn't sit there and go, oh, man, that might be a little too much.
Like the first time he said it out loud. Yeah. You go,
him and his buddies high five.
Yeah, you were going to do.
Yeah.
Shotgun in the beer after they found it.
Here's a congressman. He's taking questions from people, and then he gets annoyed with some dude. And listen to what he says to him.
Jesse Jackson Jr. is passing a bill around to increase the minimum wage to $10 an hour. Do you support that?
Probably not.
$10 an hour to give us a living wage.
How about getting a job?
I do have one.
Well, and why do you want that benefit? Get a job.
I have a job.
You should tell the guy, go get a job. He's like, I have a job. Yeah. I'm asking about raising the minimum wage.
Yeah, he didn't say like unemployment.
You're right. You remember that guy, Mr. Wizard? That TV show was a kid's TV show. Well, the guy, he was an old dude. He was kind of a dick to kids. Somebody put together a montage.
I saw this.
Yeah, a montage of just him being a prick to kids.
See those two pins, Stacy?
Yes.
Well, today I'm going to stick them in you.
Look at all the paper you wasted.
You count that as a fold?
Yes or no?
Okay.
Because I already see that it's not random.
Don't jump to conclusions.
Why isn't it random? I told you to write down random numbers.
What do you mean, not exactly? Can you see it or can't you?
Well, you're right, but for the wrong reason. Sounds logical, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Well, that's wrong.
Have you ever seen a sliced banana before?
You can't blow up a baby's nursing nipple? Well, you have one of those inside your head.
I do?
Yeah, it's called a brain. Come on, Eugene. Come on. Turn it over here like that and pull it straight up. No confidence in the science at all. You don't seem to have a great deal of confidence.
But it might come back and hit my face.
There, it's popped off.
Oh,
wow. Hit you right on the head.
What a jerk.
Go ahead, Brian, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up, man? I ran into a business name once that I thought was even funnier than that Master Bait's place. It was a smoke shop. The people were named COX. It was Cox Smokers. It's hilarious, man.
Yeah. I think, what did he say? Oh, you want to hear the Indiana Jones theme again. Yeah. It is soothing.
It is. It's like an audio blanket.
Yeah. I have another thing that just came out, actually, a video of, you know, the guy, you might have heard this, a guy shot up a theater out in Colorado.
What?
Did you hear about this?
Vaguely.
leave it to Fox News to scare the bejesus out of you when you turn it on. But this guy, he did a presentation when he was 18 on temporal illusions, I guess. And if anything, he suffered from this thing.
Hello, I'm James. Over the course of the summer, I've been working with a temporal illusion. It's an illusion that allows you to change the past.
So study subjective experience, which is what takes place inside the mind, as opposed to the external world. I've carried on his work in dealing with subjective experience.
Okay. That's some big word stuff there. I don't know what's going on there.
He lost you already.
Yeah, but you know, here's my take on that dude. He was a guy going to school to work with the mind, you know, mental stuff. My guess is, you know how like if you work in a funeral home, you become like a numb to certain things.
Right.
I'm wondering if he just became like a sponge and seen a bunch of weird stuff
and like soaked it all up and
soaked
then kind of like
it and was, then just flipped
lived,
the switch
in his own head after that.
Yeah. You know, and then the other thing is too is of course leave it to the news. They went and they did a hidden camera stuff on NBC last night, showing you how easy it is to go get an assault rifle, and it's like you just
laid it out for everybody.
Right,
else.
I know, I don't know. Just like around the time when the terrorist attack was going on, and they went and they put on video, they showed you how easy it would be for the terrorists to pollute our water supply. Here it is. It's like, come on, man, lay back a little.
Apparently, I heard his mom was I don't know if this is true or not, but his mom was a psych nurse, and she saw the signs as well. in him like prior to this.
Well, yeah, it makes sense in why she said you got the right guy.
Right.
Well, today he's going to court, so I'm sure there's going to be video of him going in. I'm sure all the Fox, you know, the NBCs and all that stuff are going to cover it live. So, of course, we're all going to be glued to that.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and I'm watching all the over the weekend, all the footage to see what the update is. And it just is creepy and tingly whenever you see that dude's face on the screen because of like how horrific the shootings were. And then they showed a picture of him with that smug smile. And you're like, I just want to beat that dude down. But then also, the guy's the number one. I mean, if you think about it, he's like a huge celebrity right now. Oh, everybody knows that guy's name. So that's exactly what he wants.
You think he was in it for like the narcissistic value?
Well, yeah, because who would booby trap? I said this on Twitter. Who would booby trap an apartment to blow people away and then tell them?
Right.
Because he wanted it. To, you know what I mean?
He wanted it bigger than it is.
He wanted them to go in and see how creative it was put together.
Right.
He wanted
how,
them to
like,
go on TV.
Could be.
Yeah, he wanted them to go on TV. And talk about how it was well put together and all that stuff. So he's what they call an evil genius, if you think about it. The way he put this thing out and made it happen. And he did it all legally, too. That's the thing.
It's crazy.
Yeah. So there you go. There's my take on it, Thomas.
That's it.
Yeah, and I'm sure we all have a take on it, too, because on Friday it was so great hearing people's take on it. I'll give an example. What do you think about the shooting? Man, it's crazy.
Yep.
We got a few minutes left to do some graffiti, Thomas, where we open up the phones. You can say whatever's on your mind at 404.
Can we do something else for the last few minutes?
What do you have an idea?
I mean, anything. But
come on. Nah. Stop.
Come on. You know what it's going to be.
Hey, okay, how about this? Brie Olson has a new song. She's the porn star, right? Here it is. Hollywood douchebag. You want graffiti?
Yeah.
She's cute in that video, though.
Yeah, she
She's
is.
She's really
Even
hot.
Even Alexis Ford is cute in that video.
Yes, our buddy Alexis Ford. You got to go to freeones.com and type in Brie Olson. They have a whole... I mean, this is what I heard. I just got to know. They have a bunch of stuff up there if you want to check it out.
The porn fairy told you?
Yeah, the porn fairy told me a good place to go get... all your needs. That or uvutu.com is good amateur stuff. It's time to give the birthday girl a kiss, Thomas.
Yeah, it is. What's up?
Oh, right. Yeah, let's do it.
Come on, pucker up, girl.
Hey, so is it really your birthday today? Because everybody on Facebook saying it is.
It is. It
okay.
is my birthday.
Oh, wow.
22, right?
23 or 22? Which one is it?
25, you guys.
Good for
Come
you.
On now.
Look at that. Nice work. And because it's her birthday, she comes bearing gifts for everyone.
That's so nice.
Isn't that nice? It's my birthday, but I'm...
Did you get anything for your birthday yet?
Yeah, I got a couple bottles of liquor.
No, of course.
What does that say?
You're a lush. Next. We knew that.
Moving along.
Not new information.
Yeah, and those bottles are already empty, and it's only been a day.
Well, that... No, that is not the case.
Do you drink wine?
Yeah.
Oh, do you?
Can you
kill a bottle of wine on your own?
No.
No?
I mean, could I? Yes.
Yeah, yeah. But do you?
Do,
know?
No.
Do you drink
do
before
not.
You go to bed every night?
Like
you have dinner
no.
and wine? No. I just recently started being okay with drinking at home. Because, you know, I don't go out anymore. So that's the only place where I can...
You loosen up a little bit, too, so...
When I'm at home...
I mostly drink at home.
Really?
Yeah, oh, yeah. I mean, it's I'm not gonna. It's expensive, and it's a it's a good social... I don't go home and, you know, hit the bottle as soon as I get home and then pass out.
See, the only reason why I can actually stand and meet, you know, and talk to anybody at, like, events is when I have a drink or something. Yeah.
And that's perfect.
I won't go.
That's why people go to bars to meet people is because it allows you to relax and, you know, take
sex.
A wall down.
Right.
Okay, we'll just go straight to that. If that's the end result, great. Yeah. That's fine, too. But
So that's good. It's your birthday.
Yeah.
She's 25, you said?
No, I'm 33.
Whoa. Yeah. Okay. All right.
Like that's so old. Guys.
Hey, I don't know. Ask, you know, in the other room is, you know, Miss Prim and Proper, our intern, Brittany, and she makes all those jokes. You guys are old. How old are you? I said, I'm 38. She says, you're old. Because, you know, because they're going to be young forever, these ones. Right?
I know. Yeah, when you're 19, you're in a bubble.
Wait till she hits the wall at 25.
Yeah, right. Exactly. And her boyfriend's got a big belly still popping his collar. then we'll see who the joke's on. Right?
Yeah, that would be pretty embarrassing.
And then by that time, we'll be on our fit kick. You know what I mean?
Right,
then we'll be in shape.
We'll be trying to get in contact with our 18-year-old selves.
Yeah, late 20s into your early 40s is when a guy hits the bar and gets sloppy. And then... into the like 41, 42, you get a divorce, then you start getting in shape.
You'll be, and then you'll start on your second marriage.
Exactly.
And, yeah.
See?
That's the way it goes.
That's the curve.
Then she'll be knocking on doors.
Yeah, exactly.
Right?
You
yeah.
can be fat when you're in a relationship, but as soon as you're broken up, you're like, well, I can't get a date looking like this.
Yeah. You're fat in a relationship because your wife will feed you a ton of food, so no one else will talk
to you. So nobody will want you.
That's why, right? Uh-huh.
Exactly. That's what I tell myself.
It's actually a good racket. Yeah. It's a good game.
It is. hey, listen. 404-741-9696 is our phone number. One sentence, say whatever's on your mind. Go. You're on the air. You're first. Go ahead.
Hello. Hey, sweetie. I just wanted to say hello to you. This is Chris.
Damn it. That's the rule is to move on. I want to talk to her. Yeah, she sounded hot. She's gone.
You can break the rule. It's your show.
No. Graffiti, you're on the air.
Why are you crying? It was Kiss that just raped you.
Graffiti, you're on the air. Go.
Hey, I hear you guys are throwing a party on Lake Lanier, which is great. You're already brain dead, so it won't matter.
That's a Bud Light boat. We're going to be doing that on August 4th. Yeah. Sign up for it up on the Project Family Facebook page. Graffiti, go ahead.
I bet Todd and Trey never wore cheek Band-Aids.
Right.
Graffiti, you're on the air. Go ahead.
I slept with my daughter's daycare teacher. In hindsight, probably not the best idea.
Call back and tell the whole story, please. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Dum dum dum. We're so gay.
We're so gay. Graffiti, one sentence, please.
Thomas is a douche.
Wow.
Agreed.
Graffiti, go ahead.
Oh, that's hot.
Hello, Graffiti.
Yeah, have you guys heard the mayor of Party City? Where are you going?
Graffiti, you're on the air.
Hot soup.
Oh, old school. Graffiti, one sentence, please.
Penis.
Graffiti, go ahead.
I want to hear more about the mayor of Party Town.
Party City, jerk off.
Come on.
Graffiti, go ahead.
Ranger Rick's Rectal Reconstruction Services at your service.
I knew
See?
It.
I told you.
Oh, yeah.
I told you.
What could we? You wanted to hear the douchebag song again?
No.
All right, good.